you go back in, if you go back onto OBS, and if you start recording. Oh,
I did.
What the hell?
I did. Okay, shut down, share screen.
Right, I'll end the Skype call and you can get back on Twitch.
Wait a minute. Bloody hell. Can you guys hear me? Ja oder nein? Can you hear me? Ja oder nein? Audio coming over my microphone. Ausgezeichnet! Well, first off, I hate this rendition, so let's improve it a bit. Let me know if you hear this. Yeah, some music. Panzer 4. I can't believe I overslept. Gunny is gonna have my head for this. Wait. Oh, never mind. It's my first day of class. Shit! It's the first day of class! I really should have written down the address. I have no idea where the hell this school is. East End Americana. Still? Well, give it 30 seconds. How is my volume compared to it? Come on, you're my tech expert. All right, good. I have no idea where the hell this school is. Why did they put a tank school in downtown Akihabara anyway? The fuck? Come to think of it, I haven't seen any military bases near here either. Jesus, this place is laid out more screwed up than Albany. Hell, I really am gonna be late if I can't figure out where I'm going. I should ask for directions. Looks like that mechanic shop is open. Same with the convenience store. I'll ask one of them. Do I go to the mechanic, or do I go to the convenience store? Alright. To the convenience store! God damn it, Pulpy! God damn it! Oh, the convenience store probably has a map or something. Ignore my idiot friend. The convenience store probably has a map or something. I have to remember to click on the correct window. You walk into the convenience store, and the bright fluorescent lights illuminate the whole store in a blinding haze. Danke, Poppy. You peruse the local travel guides on the rack next to this week's newest manga releases, but find nothing that mentions a military base. And god damn it, they don't have the newest edition of Ribbon Warrior either. I guess I'll have to ask the cashier. You take your place in line behind an older salaryman, his hands full of adult comics and snack food. What a weird country. The man in front of you finishes paying, and you step up to the counter. Alright. Excuse me, I'm trying to find the tank school. Do you have any maps that would help, or... Before he can answer, you hear a girl laughing from another part of the store. You turn around to see her walk up next to you with a piece of toast in hand and breadcrumbs on her blouse. So do I attempt a female voice? Oh god. I'm just gonna steal Poppy's shtick. Tank school? Are you our new teacher? She asks excitedly in what could only be described as the least American accent ever. No, I'm transferring here. Do you know where it is? What? Transfer? You're joking! Before you can speak again, the shopkeeper interrupts. If you're not going to buy something, can you please move? Hey, OG son, give us a minute. Wait, Emperor Sherman, you still owe me 500 yen from the other day. He says quickly with a look of realization on his face. The girl grabs you by the collar and starts pulling you towards the door. I'll pay you later. Tomorrow, Oji-san. Get back here! He calls after the girl as she starts running with you in tow. You spend the next few minutes walking double time to keep up with this girl. She talks to you the entire way, but is rambling off on so many tangents that you can't keep track of what she's trying to explain. It's weirdly silent. And so here we are! She shouts excitedly, sticking her arm out to point at the building before you. This is a tank school? You say questioningly. Well, that's what it says on the sign, doesn't it? Actually, should be. Well, that's what it says on the sign, doesn't it? Senpai's going to chew us out, though, for being late. Let's try and sneak in quick. She says hurriedly. Before you can respond, she's already marching through the gate to the school. This is going to be a long day.
You are late for class, maggot!
A tall man dressed in a Marine drill sergeant uniform shouts at you before you're even halfway through the door. I'm sorry, sir.
Don't you sir me, maggot. I work for a living.
Gunnery sergeant, I mean.
Have you forgotten how to address a senior non-commissioned officer, maggot?
Sergeant, this recruit is sorry for being late, but this recruit was lost and this girl showed me the way, sergeant. You gesture to point at M4 Sherman, but she's not at your side anymore. And you can see she's slowly sneaking closer to her desk while the sergeant was focused on you, that little bitch. The sergeant's head snaps to the right to look at her.
Where do you think you're going, Sherman?
Yes, everyone is British, I guess.
Oh, senpai, Sit down, Sherman. You and the new recruit are both on cleaning detail this afternoon.
Aye, Sergeant. You both say as you salute the instructor and take your seats at the back of the class. Why am I doing this? Where did I go wrong in life?
We shall fight them on the beaches.
After a few minutes of listening to him lecture on fire support doctrine, you hear a whisper to your right.
Psst! New guy! Psst! What's your name?
Erwin. You whisper back.
What are you doing here at tank school?
That's what I want to know. I'm supposed to be studying tank warfare in an officer's academy, but you're all dressed like high schoolers.
Well, duh. We're tanks. What? Tanks? Didn't you read the sign up front? Tank school. It's pretty obvious.
Yeah, but I thought it was tank school. Like, normal. Yes, naval uniforms at the tank academy. Somebody thought it was a good idea to mash up Gup and Kankale. And not a single Congo in sight. Or Kaga. Congo and Kaga. No, never mind.
No, it's tank school. For tanks.
That makes absolutely no fucking sense.
Got the chatter back now, recruits. Don't worry, I'll introduce you to everyone at lunch.
She whispers before going back to doodling on her desk. Oh, God.
This is going to be a weird day.
Jesus, what have I gotten into? I really hope I'm at the right place. Command will give me hell if they think I went AWOL. Probably fucking shoot me. Yeah, that wouldn't be such a bad thing. A few hours later, it's probably almost lunchtime. After the sound of the bell, all of the, quote, tanks in the classroom start unpacking their lunch bags and heading into the hall.
New guy, follow me. I'll show you where the mess hall is.
And the meth hall.
That's where we keep the good shit. It's this nice blue color. How do you think we stay so happy all the time?
She shouts excitedly from across the hall as she starts skipping away. A shorter girl to your right looks at you and frowns.
You'll be sitting with us today.
Great.
She says as she rolls her eyes and follows Sherman down the hallway.
You walk into the school's mess hall, and already there are tons of students sitting at the various tables together.
I will make an effort to read any typos exactly as written.
On the far side of the room, you see Sherman and a few other girls chatting.
She sees you, she jumps up.
Hey, new guy! Over here!
You walk over to the group of girls, and one by one, Sharon begins to introduce you.
Owen, meet Panzer Fool.
Hiya, I'm a junior here, and I'm from Germany.
She says with a wink.
And you're a tank too?
Of course, I'm Panzerkampfwagen für Ausführung F2, aber mein Freundin just call me Panzer 4.
She giggles.
Ah, she's an F2.
Okay, so that's what Miho had at the Pravda match.
Long barrel, 75mm gun, slightly improved armor.
And this little cutie is T-34-chan.
Sherman says, pulling on the pink-haired girl's sleeve.
Cut it out, Sherman.
Oh, come on, T-chan!
Ugh, hi. I'm tank of year 34, but everyone just calls me T-34. Except Sherman.
That's right, she's a little T-chan!
I'm not that short.
Shorter than both of us!
Sherman and Panzer IV laugh in unison.
It's obvious this isn't the first time they've had this discussion.
Wait, so if you're a Panzer IV, and she's a T-34, don't you two...
We used to have our differences, but we got over it. Yeah, T-34?
She says, nudging T-34 to speak.
Right. Who needs European hegemony in the Crimea anyway?
Sherman quickly cuts her off.
Well, as close to over it as I can get, she says, poking them both in the ribs.
Which, given the positioning, is actually something of a feat. She's over there, T-34 is there, and Panzer IV is all the way over there.
So then, everyone here is a tank.
Yeah. Well, except for the teachers.
And you?
She says, embarrassed.
I'm beginning to think this is some sort of joke.
Well, it seems normal to me.
She smiles.
Well, yeah, but
you're a tank. And a girl.
And you're not even Bismarck or Prince Eugen.
I still don't know why I'm here. I was supposed to be studying armored warfare, not how to be a tank.
Well, go ask Kanoi Sergeant Hartman. He's so kawaii, even if he seems like he's a meanie.
Oh, God. I don't think I've ever heard a sergeant called kawaii. Ugh.
You guys having fun so far? The chat has gotten disturbingly silent. On top of the dead silent game.
Oh wow, this is way behind.
Oh crap, I just skipped a scene. Oh shit.
Shit, 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 shit. And you can't go back.
Nope. Nope. Oh god.
Follow me, Irvin. We can talk to Herr Sergeant.
I don't know. He doesn't really seem like a talking type. Is there anyone else?
Uh-oh. Lag! Lag! Lag!
Playoffs!
None of you are going to... Oh, okay. If the audio syncs, then I'm not worried. Well, Panzer IV is a low-tier tank, so fuck you. So... Why am I on the Obsidian Forum? Go away. Well, it is a low-tier tank. I don't know. I don't play World of Tanks. But I think it's like 4 or 5, something like that. I've got Japanese destroyers that out-level it.
You will see.
He just seems grumpy, but he's actually really sweet.
We are talking about the same person, right? Right? Crazy German bitch.
That's only because he was in the war desk.
That's not German.
Wait, he was?
As you speak, the sound of a tank motor stalling suddenly roars behind you.
Ah, look out!
That was my background noise, guys.
I'm so sorry. Is he okay? Ah!
You really need to be more careful. You almost crushed him.
I know, Senpai. I walked out again, but I couldn't stop.
It's okay. He's gonna be alright. Just don't push yourself so hard, okay?
Hi. Senpai, he's waking up.
You took quite a fall there.
Oh, why? Where am I?
Don't worry, you're quite all right.
Fell into a tiger, yeah? How? What happened to me?
Tiger One had a little slip up and her transmission jammed up again. You know, you really should wear a helmet when you're around tanks. Didn't you read the field manual?
No, I did not read the goddamn Panzer Fibrin. Field manual?
Never mind. Anyway, Tiger, come over here. It's well enough to see.
I'm sorry for running you over.
She looks really sad. I should probably say something.
Fuck you!
No, you ran me over. Go away! Who are you people?
I'm the school's mechanic, but for you today, I'm the nurse.
So she is, like, Flutter Tank here of Tank 2? Or an actual human being? That's not something they answer, is it?
This girl's Tiger 1. She's Panzer 4's cousin.
The blonde girl blushes red and her lip starts to quiver.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean. It's just.
Look, I'm really alright.
See?
You say, balancing on one foot on the ground and the other resting against the bed. As the girl starts to you look at the nurse worriedly.
What? How do I grammar? What?
As the girl starts to, you look at the nurse worriedly.
As she starts to what? You need a verb there. English, motherfucker. Do you speak it?
Tiger One breaks down a lot. You might want to let me handle this from here. Why don't you take the rest of the day off?
Sure. Yeah, I'll see myself off, you say as you pry the crying girl off you. I don't remember the part where she accosted me, but okay. You walk out into the school hallway and take a moment to catch your thoughts. What the fuck is going on? What kind of place is this? You mutter when you notice a girl staring at you from behind a corner of the wall. She ducks back around the corner as soon as you take a look at her. Hello? Is anyone there? She peeks her head. She peeks. Jesus. EEK! That is... Oh, Lord. Anyway, she peeks her head back out, blushing red and looking very shy.
And very red, if you catch my meaning, tovarish. I'm sorry. Are you the new boy? Yeah, I guess I am.
Well, I wanted to ask you something, if that is okay.
Sure.
Well, have you ever been inside of a tank?
Ah! Well, if I'm training to be a tank or an armored corps officer, so yes, probably in training. Well, once in training, we did have a tank maintenance class. It was pretty fun, actually. Got to fire a couple of rounds through the barrel.
Oh, so she let you touch her.
Whoa. Normal tank, not a tank girl. Not whatever you are. I've been on a battleship, too. Doesn't mean a filled with Congo. Been on an aircraft carrier, too.
Oh, tee-hee. Well, you're coming with me. Let's get a drink.
I actually kind of got to go.
Oh, come on, please.
I got the feeling she's going to stab me in the face if I do this one. So, what should it be? What should it be? Let's see. I would say Poppy went with her. So what do we do, folks? You tell me. That's one vote for yes! Wait! Wait a minute, is that a vote for yes or a vote for shivving? You guys. Alright, let's see what happens. In for a penny, in for a pound. I said no! Jesus!
Oh. Okay, I'll leave. She walks down the hallway sullenly and disappears around the corner.
God, what a fucking nut! You mutter to yourself before heading home. I'm alive! For now! Uh-oh, it's dark! It's already dark outside as you approach your apartment building. Oh god! Oh god! This is setting up for something! This is setting up for something! I am going to get knifed, aren't I?
What a weird girl, you mutter to yourself as you fumble with your keys. Yes, she was sweet, but damn, something's up with her. You open the front door, go upstairs to your room.
Do I have psycho strings rigged up?
You sit on your bed and take your shoes off, one by one.
Oh, no. I mean, could you have been any more forward?
Oh, God, I'm probably going to see her tomorrow at school.
She was pretty forward.
I gotta figure out what her deal. Oh god, don't tell me I locked myself into some horrible therapy thing. Oh god, no. Do not want.
I need to figure out what her deal is. Hell, what any of this tank school stuff is.
Can't exactly ask the sergeant. And Sherman was about as much help as tits on a bowl.
Wait! That nurse mentioned a manual. I bet there's a surplus store in town with all that stuff. Hey! I'll go there tomorrow. They gotta know something at least.
You lay your head back on the pillow and fall fast asleep before you even know it.
Alright, we're gonna save here. End of the first day. Maybe we're gonna save, or maybe the game's gonna crash. Oh. Huh? Ah, there we go. How does I save? Computer 101. Oh, my head. Back to tank school. Great. Gonna figure out what the hell's going on today. Well, maybe if I hurry, I can stop by the commander's office before class starts. Says tank school, all right. See? Tank school. Right there. Doesn't look like any places you could run a tank, but okay. And here we are. It literally does say tank school right on the sign. This is still fucked up. Now, where was that admin office? It's got to be around here somewhere. Oh, wait, here it is. Just as you were about to open the door, you were greeted by...
Where do you think you're going, maggot?
Ah!
You're 2 seconds away from getting smoked, recruit.
Sergeant, this recruit wanted to speak to command regarding his placement at the school, Sergeant.
Do you not like to train, recruit? Do you not like me? I am offended. I will smoke your ass so hard the base fire crew will come running. We shall fight them in the halls. I will bottle your tears and drink it on my next run. Now, get to class.
Aye, Sergeant. Oh shit, that didn't do me much good. Yeah, I guess surplus store is the new plan. I'll swing by there after class. I've got to know something at least. You reach the classroom and walk inside, taking a seat beside M4 Sherman. Oh. I don't want to sit next to Sherman. Where the... I wanted to do that, but I couldn't manage it. It's too shouty.
Yo! New guy! Looks like you did come back. Hey, T-34, you see that? You owe me 500 yen!
What?!
We were taking bets that you wouldn't show back up. Looks like I'm $5 richer.
Before you can reply, Gunnery Sergeant Hartman enters the room.
Hatches closed, tanks, and mouth shut, recruit.
This is going to be a long day. There's someone that's coming. A few hours later. The classroom empties at the bell. And the tanks are all chatting in the hallway. Another day of class over with. I guess I should figure out where that surplus store is before I go off searching for it. Who do I ask, though? The other end of the hallway, you see Panzer 4 and T-34 packing their school bags. Oh, it's that German girl, a tank girl thing. The other Russian one. I guess I can ask one of them. Excuse me. T-34, right?
Duh. What do you want?
I'm kinda lost. Do you know where the surplus store is?
Yes. Why?
I need to find it?
Uh-huh. And I'm guessing you need my help finding it.
That would be nice.
That it would. All right, let's go.
T-34 leads you down the busy Akihabara streets. Anime billboards, girls dressed as French maids, and bustling tourists are everywhere. And not one little fuckwit shouting, Nico, Nico, Ni, thank God. As you walk along, T-34 seems oddly quiet.
Hey, so thanks for showing me the way.
Don't mention it. Like, seriously. Don't mention it. Ever.
Do you dislike me or something?
No, I...
She kind of has like an Anami thing going. The short hair, the hair clip. Because I could probably find it from here if...
Erwin, you're fine. But I was wondering something.
Yeah, sure.
Why are you here?
Huh?
Why are you here at tank school?
Well, that's kind of my question. I mean, that's why I'm going to the store.
Well.
And to be perfectly honest, I'm still in, like, tank shock over the whole thing.
Yeah, very clever. Tank shock. Like I haven't heard that joke before.
Huh? Oh, tank shock. No, that wasn't supposed to be a pun, but I'm using that from now on.
Please don't.
Anyway, I'm sure you feel out of place here.
Yeah, just imagine if you went to infantry school.
I'd crush everyone.
Right. Yeah. Oh, so you're IS2's sister, right?
We're cousins. Distant ones.
Bad blood?
Dead family. Just try sitting through family reunion with Stalin and his daughter.
Wait, you mean...
What do you think the IS stood for? Intricate Slavs?
Well, I never thought it meant Joseph Stalin. Except I knew it didn't mean that. Because I like tanks.
Fortunately, crazy only runs in that family.
I've never really known much of my family. I know my grandfather was a war hero, but when my family moved to America, we changed our names, so I've never been able to find out who he was. Yeah, okay, Erwin.
Four velts. Limor, anyway. What is that, French?
German, I think.
Ah, well, you're not the worst German I've met.
Met a lot of Germans in your time? Music's gone? Bah!
Huh.
Maybe I just went too long. Met a lot of Germans in your time?
You could see that. Hey, here's the surplus store.
Oh, good. Do you want to come in?
No. It's fine. I'm opposed to war now.
Opposed to war? What about the annexation of Crimea?
That is not war. That was liberation of Russian-speaking minority.
Yeah, you have a nice night, T-34.
You too, Erwin.
T-34 walks off down the road, leaving you alone in front of the store. Whew, what a weird girl. Each one's crazier than the last.
Why couldn't I have been dumped into the Kankole universe instead?
They're at least sane. You walk into the surplus store. Oh no, not this part. Inside, the walls are lined with weapons from various eras, and toward the back, you can see some bookshelves stocked with what look like field manuals and films. A few other customers mill about the store, and a bored-looking shopkeeper sits behind the counter. Whew. Glad to be in here. At least it seems normal. The shopkeeper looks up as you near the counter.
Welcome to Callius' Supplies. Surplus. Can I help you with anything?
Otto Carius.
Wehrmacht tank ace.
Interesting reference. At least it's not Wittmann, who was SS. Do you have headlight fluid? Hey, so at the school just down the road, there's a lot of girls there who refer to themselves as tank girls. What's that all about? Oh, them. Kind of weird. Oh, sorry. Oh, it's him.
Kind of failed at first, but they make up for it in other ways. Pretty, aren't they?
Sure?
Hey, do I hear talk about tank girls?
Oh, God!
Oh, sweet Saint Mary and the hood of a Mercedes-Benz.
Ow.
What a surprise, recruit Lemoore, isn't it?
Yes, sir. God, I was not expecting him here.
Hey! Don't you dare, sir, me. Check your eyes or I'll remove them from their sockets.
Yes, Sarge.
Hey, Sarge, I'm curious about something.
All right, but make it quick, recruit. I may be your sergeant, but I am not your mother.
He's getting too Australian, goddammit.
I wouldn't want to ask my father, much less my mother. I've noticed that the school has a very, interesting student body.
Suddenly, the sergeant's face turns from a frown to a sly grin. All right, I'm going to try Arlie Ermey instead of Churchill. Oh, I see. You mean the girls, right? Like what you've seen so far?
He elbows you in the ribs a little too hard.
Well, it's certainly not what I've expected, to say the least. Neither was it for me, but like they taught you in basic, adapt and overcome. Not like I have much of a choice at this point.
Maybe I should try getting in touch with the administration again and figure out why the hell I'm here. Say, Sarge, I have another question for you. Alright, guys, you pick. Do we ask how long or what his story is? I'm kind of curious, to be honest. Also, if the music is dead... Oops. Wrong music. Hehe. Dort wurde Morgenwind Träume verweht. Story. All right. What did you do before working as a drill instructor?
Beforehand, I was a gunner, and up until this position, was a tank commander. Tanks are my passion. Hell, I believe I've been in every tank out there. Light tanks, heavy tanks, tank destroyers, you name it, I've probably been in it.
Oh my. His eyes sparkle a little too much for your comfort.
Oh dear. Let me ask you something, recruit. Have much experience of tanks?
Little in basic training.
Ha! I knew you weren't that much of a little poof. So, tell me, what she look like?
She? Sarge, are we talking about...
Well, maybe this'll straighten you out, recruit.
He hands you the DVD that he's held tightly in his hand since the beginning of the conversation. You glance quickly at the title. Triple XXX Ammo Racks. It has a picture of the Panzerkampfwagen 8 Maus super heavy tank on the cover.
Best sind die Gesichter.
Shit! Sergeant, is this... He slaps you on the back, laughing.
It's the only gift you're... Oh, sorry. It's the only gift you're getting, recruit. So enjoy it!
He laughs to himself as he walks out of the store, waving goodbye to the shopkeeper. This place just keeps getting weirder and weirder. Yes, 9Xs. You tuck the DVD under your arm and start heading home, apparently having not paid for it. Back in the street, day has turned to night, and the bustle of tourists is replaced by the bustle of slightly more intoxicated tourists. As you walk home through Akihabara, you hear a voice call out from behind you. Nine! Nine!
Oh, Erwin!
Oh, hey, IS-2, what's up?
You wouldn't believe how hard you are to catch up with. I swear I had to jog the last 3 blocks.
You followed me for 3 blocks, huh?
No, for 6. I just jogged for the last 3.
Okay, that's mildly disturbing.
So let's go out.
You know, as tempting as that sounds, I was actually just heading home.
That's okay. I go with you.
That's not...
Come on, let's go.
I asked too, that's really sweet, really. But I need to go. I should go.
Oh, okay. Will you call me?
Oh boy. Part of me wants to play with fire. Part of me wants to play with fire.
Is she Albanian? Technically, I...
Is she Albanian?
Well, I do live near Albany.
So...
am I risking a knife in my throat?
So what do you think, folks? Hi, Cray. So, yes or no, do we say we'll call? Yet. Look, I'm really not interested.
Oh, wait. Never mind. I'll just call you. Bye, Erwin.
Maybe, Cray.
IS2 smiles at you as she walks off down the street.
Weird tanks, weird city. Weird tanks, weird city. Weird tanks, weird city. Weird tanks, weird city.
It's good to finally be home. You toss the sergeant's DVD on top of your desk. I was hoping at least the sergeant would have been normal. Looks like that ain't happening. I guess I'll try to get some rest before class tomorrow. You lay on your bed and drift off to sleep. Do dream dreams of being marooned at a school for boat girls. The normal girl reads the wrong history books. So, in review, many large caliber rounds, AT or otherwise, may bounce against properly angled armor. Even the thinnest armor can bounce a high velocity round if the angle is severe enough. As such, take care to present as little of your armor as possible. Avoid showing the enemy your broadside. And be extremely careful of...
oh, God.
And be extremely careful of penetration of...
no, I can't even say it.
Shit. Rear penetration sounds right up Gunny's alley. Sherman? Yeah. Shield point does have a thing for flanking maneuvers. Really? Because I have some personal intel that he prefers ammo racks. Big ammo racks. Oh? And which do you prefer? She grins teasingly. I am not answering that question, Sherman. Lame. Recruit! What are you whispering about back there? Sir? Don't you sir me, maggot! Ow! Suddenly, you have an idea. Oh, fuck.
No!
This recruit has a question regarding penetration. Go on. Well, actually, modern AP rounds are subcaliber, so it's the sectional density that matters. So it's something... Well, we'll discuss armor penetration later. This recruit is wondering whether or not the size of the bore affects penetration, sir. Is it better to have a large bore, long barrel, or just the skill to aim well? What the hell are you implying, recruit? This recruit is simply inquiring as to... This recruit is simply inquiring as to how the sergeant prefers to penetrate tanks. Is it even possible with a smaller gun? Nope, not generally. That's why you had the massive upscale in bore sizes during World War II. They started with 20mm guns. That was good enough in the Spanish Civil War. Not so much later on. Oh shit, he's pissed.
Wait. How big is your bore?
She whispers.
Sherman, not now! Class, outside. We're having a practical drill in angling armor. Recruit Lemore here has just graciously volunteered himself as the first target.
Sir?
Don't you sir me, maggot! Outside! Now!
I've just switched to a generic southern accent because this is wrecking my throat. Oh, my boot goes so far up your ass it hits teeth! The snarly back of the throat gravelly thing is rough.
Alright, tanks. Which of you is going to be the first one to take a shot at Recruit Lemore here?
Feldpepper, he cannot angle his armor.
Well, he best learn real quick then. I volunteer, senpai. Well, if it isn't the bright American star herself. Front and center!
Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit!
What type of round should I load, senpai? Total line, Sherman! Load HE! Oi! Recruit! Angle your arm up!
Oh!
Angle it!
There's supposed to be music in this part.
Nope.
Whoa! No! Alright, so... She's on the left. So if I angle to the left, I will actually... Wait, if I angle right, I'll present... Or if I angle left, I will present a narrower profile.
Who the fuck am I kidding? I'm screwed!
Round's ready, Sergeant.
Take aim!
Sherman, wait, please don't shoot me. You don't want to do this. Please, please, please.
Come on, man. Angle! Here it comes!
Shit!
Fire!
Woohoo!
Blah!
There's supposed to be menacing music there. It makes me sad that it's not. Here, you get this instead. Guys, do you hear the music? I think my audio is set up fucked up.
Ah, bojemoy, playback devices.
What do you mean not plugged in?
Huh. Erwin?
Uh,
Nope. OBS. God? Is that you? God, am I dead?
Unfortunately, you are not, recruit! It seems the pinnacle of American engineering couldn't hit the broadside of a goddamn aircraft carrier!
Why is she shooting at a Akagi-senpai?
Tomorrow, we will be having class in the field. You are dismissed, maggot.
I just had a shell go off next to me. Oh, now I'm curious. Oh, that's not good. Oh, no, 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 no. No, no, no. Recording. Uh-huh. Playback. Yeah, you. Oh no! Without the... No, I can't get that window to close. Ooh, slow internet is slow. Okay, you guys should hear weird techno music. Tell me if you hear weird techno music. Because I apparently cannot. I'm an idiot. I had my headset turned all the way down. Well, actually, that is a problem if you don't hear it. Remember, we're on like a 30-second delay. So I'm going to let this run for 60 seconds. You let me know if you hear anything. Okay, good. All right, now let's shut off Kagamisaki. Alright, we're still in the game. We're still in the game. Oh, wow, yeah, there's loud piano. Hi, loud piano. Am I dead?
No, but you came close.
I'm alright then.
You know, Sherman should really not have fired. She always does things without thinking.
How'd I get here?
Just get some rest. I can't carry you home every time you get yourself into trouble, baka.
Well, thanks, you know?
It's not like I wanted to or anything, stupid.
Come on! Can you get any more prototypically tsundera than that? Oh, yeah, sorry. I turned up the loud piano. How's this? Oh, no! Oh, no, that's good, that's good. Okay, so I can still speak and not get horribly overloaded. All right. Hey, it's my first stream, guys. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. It's Sundara playing all over again. But now he's Sundara tank.
Like, it's just that the sergeant told me to.
Well, hey, thanks anyway, T-34.
Yeah, you're welcome, everyone. You know,
It's nice. Nice? Being here.
T-34 moves closer to you.
Hi there!
Erwin, I wanted to ask you, do you think you...
God damn it, Sherman!
Yo, new guy! I'm gonna make her California.
I wanted to make sure you were all right.
I'm all... He's fine, Sherman.
Well, I brought you some snacks to cheer you up.
She hands you a small bag of pretzels.
God damn, why didn't I think of that before? These are expired, Sherman.
I said brought, not bought, man.
I'm going to head home. Get some rest, Erwin. Yeah. Phew! She seemed mad.
Was it something I said?
No, it's alright, Sherman. Anyway, thanks for checking up on me. I think I was just mostly surprised by the shot. I feel fine now.
Good, because tomorrow Sergeant is having us do some outdoor thing. He wanted me to bring you to the address.
Well, I have to get assistance with doing Jersey. Texas is take, well, generic Southern is taken. And Minnesota, I really can't do without going into some kind of weird Muppet creature. Okay.
She hands you a slip of paper with lat-long coordinates. 3741 North, 14102 East.
Hold that thought!
One 14102. Now it's 3741. 14102 East. Russian Academy of Science.
What?
Andrea Sykon, medical doctor and department chair.
Watson, let's review the electronic medical record of the next patient.
No problem.
It's a pretty huge file.
Done. Sorry for the wait. As part of our research, I also...
This is why it takes me forever to get anything done. I get... If we could get X to do it, I'd have him do the drill sergeant.
North. East.
There we go. So this... address. I don't read kanji. So I don't know what it says. It is in Japan, I think. Okay, oh, it's in Fukushima. Oh, okay. Koyama. Tomioka. Okuma. Sure. It is a legit location. It's an address, though. It's near the Otazawa Post Office, and the Garden Center, and the Asian Restaurant, because that narrows it down, right? And the Okura Dam. Ooh, what's this? This looks like a harbor. What is it? Fukushima Prefecture, Kitara, Otazawa. Yeah, but what's... All right. Anyway. Yep. Oh, sorry. Nope, she's not Australian anymore.
Yeah. See you tomorrow, new guy.
Oh, I'm still screwing it up. I can't even do a surfer accent. I had Keanu Reeves for a second. I had it for a second. Ugh. Oh, yeah, there's noise. Ooh, a train. Oh, it's got a train. Best game ever. The rumble of the train rolling along the tracks makes a rhythmic pattern. Fuck you. Makes a rhythmic pattern as you sit on the soft seats of the Interregion Express. Can you guys even hear me over the audio? Let's turn it down a little more, hey? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Loud train is loud. Okay, that's better. You tap your foot to the sound of the tracks. Soft sound has lulled you off to sleep more than once on this trip. Gunny sure did pick the furthest place possible for a field off, didn't he? Suddenly, the train makes a turn, and the warm summer sun casts its light through the windows. Beach episode! Oh. That's just a stupid train. Whoa! The sea stretches all the way to the horizon, and the crystal blue water shimmers in the sunlight. I will shout over train! Japan sure is beautiful. I wonder what he has in mind for us, though. This is probably going to be some god-awful Navy SEAL fitness thing. At least I might pick up a higher score on my underwater knife-fighting test this time. The train begins slowing down as it approaches the station. When it stops, the door is open and you can smell the scent of sea salt on the wind. And no more train, which means Moff got to get turned down. You get up and walk off the train. Don't hold them walking. The town looks like it was built on the side of a large hill descending into the coast. All in all, it's a picturesque seaside town. Damn pretty place for a day of training. Well, I guess I'll head down to the beach and see what Gunny has in store for us. And there's the soundtrack! You arrive on the beach a few minutes later, and the deep blue water reflects the morning sun. As you approach, the rest of the tanks are already chatting in a group. Alvin! She shouts and waves you over. Oh, so you made it.
It's nice to see you, Alvin.
She says shyly. All of a sudden, totalitarian rule doesn't seem so bad, does it? Hey, everyone! Wait! Where's Sherman?
Probably late, as always.
Oh, well, here comes the gunny.
Alright, maggots. After yesterday's catastrophe, you are going to work! You are going to sweat! You will know pain!
Okay. My audio good?
And so, as punishment, you're all spending the day at the beach!
Nein! My treads are going to get ruined in the sand! I don't think this is play for my transmission, Sergeant.
You should have thought of that! Before blowing up the classroom!
If I remember correctly,
Sherman blew up the classroom.
after you ordered her to fire off range.
I brought all of you out here to have a nice time, and honestly, I'm feeling really under attack right now.
Quit being a little bitch about it, Sarge. And that is why T-34 is best girl.
All right. You can spend a day in town.
Sergeant, won't command get mad if we came all the way out here and don't do any training?
God damn it, recruit! Fine! Field craft thing! Go on a scavenger hunt or something!
A scavenger hunt? Oh, kawaii!
And that's how you speak Japanese in a German accent. What do you expect us to go find?
Do I look like your mother? Damn it, recruit! Fine, I'll write each of you a list.
The sergeant pulls the notebook out of his pocket and begins writing out a scavenger hunt list for each of you.
Alright, split up into teams of two and go find shit. Don't finish before 1600. At least one of us is going to enjoy the beach today.
I'm being invited to move my streaming site about 4 miles down the road.
So, I wonder who will call this, yeah?
I don't think Sarge's ribbons are regulation either. Then again, he's not even wearing an Eagle Globe and Anchor. Yeah, you guys know how this is going by this point. Hey, T-34, do you want to do the scavenger hunt together?
Not really. I mean, what's on your list?
Let's see. You look down at your list and read it aloud. Chemlight batteries, keys for a Humvee, and an ID-10T form.
What's next? Grid squares?
I don't think we're getting any of those.
Well, you could say I took a few from Ukraine lately.
Okay, well, anyways, let's just work together.
All right, I guess you can take a walk, Baka. Very хорошо.
You and T-34 walk up a slight hill from the beach towards the town. So what's on your list, T-34?
Gunny wants me to find tiny umbrella, tequila, salt, lime, sandals, and a yukata. How bothersome.
It looks like a full day's work.
For some people.
Nothing. Let's get started.
Sure.
Oops. Alright, well, I bet we can snag some tiny umbrellas from that convenience store. Let's go check. You know, I've never been in a convenience store that sold little tiny umbrellas for nice drinks. It's probably worth a look.
Bing bong.
You and T-34 walk into the convenience store. And it looks eerily similar to the one near your apartment because they reused the art asset! I actually did open up the art assets for this game. It's hilariously sparse. Huh, funny. They use the same layout as the one in our town. Suddenly, you hear a shout from another part of the store.
Hey, look who it is. Erwin and T-Chan.
Gah! Shatterman, I told you not to call me that.
She says, annoyed. Sherman walks up with a bottle of soda in her hand and takes another swig.
Oh, relax, T-Chan.
I didn't expect to find the two of you here.
Where were you this morning? We were meeting on beach.
I was running a little bit late and then I got thirsty. I'm heading there now.
Well, we're on scavenger hunt now. Gunny's orders.
Awesome! Can I come with you guys?
Get the fuck out of here!
Well, I'm kind of doing this with T-34 at the moment.
Oh, so it's that kind of scavenger hunt, eh?
She elbows you in the side.
What? No, that's not...
She blushes.
Don't worry, guys. I should go report to Gunny anyways. Oh, before I go, I saw this super cute cafe down the road. You two should, like, totally check it out. See ya!
Sorry about that, T-34.
Whatever.
Anyway, I found the umbrellas. Can't believe they have them. Let's check out that cafe.
All right.
So, yes. Kommt zu uns! Division Hermann Göring! What the fuck?
When Popey did this... So I just want to point something out. When Popey did this, you couldn't see that poster. Panzer IV was standing in front of it. Now look at what happens. You and T-34 enter the cafe together. Oh, she stands to the side. Snotty little shit.
Oh, of course they had to make this place look American. Everything these days just has to be American.
You sure you hate her, Popey?
Hey, aren't you American, Erwin?
Yeah, although my grandfather's from Germany.
Too bad he got away. Anyways, at least you're not French.
Hey, while we're here, you want to get something to drink? This tea smells pretty good.
Sure, why not?
All right, let's see. I'll get a green tea, please. Help, I need a shopkeeper voice.
And what will you have there, little lady? If you have Russian tea, I'll take that. If not, regular tea. Blick.
Yeah, she sure has interesting and varied tastes. You and T-34 take a seat at a small table and wait for your drinks to be done.
Dort wo der Morgenwind Träume verweht. All right, kids, here are your drinks.
He sets them in front of you and returns to the counter. You and T-34 take a few minutes to finish your drinks.
It's not Arnold. It's supposed to be...
What? Oh! My God, no.
But I should have done Arnold for Tiger. God damn.
Where were you earlier? That was really, really good. And I hate tea.
The only thing that warms you up better than tea on cold Moscow morning is a good hot borscht soup.
I can't say I ever had a chance to go to Moscow. Scarily enough, I might be at some point. Oh my God, T-34, shut up.
If you ever get the chance, definitely go there and visit. The architecture, the history.
The people, the city lights, especially the parks and small forests around. All of it is beautiful. Once you're there,
you won't want to leave.
Maybe I will. You'll have to show me around when I'm there, though.
Well, hold up. You mean like a date or something? Yeah, why not?
You smile at her.
Pull your skull, pull, yeah.
I guess that's okay.
Anyway, I'm sure we can find the rest of the stuff on your list if we look around town some more. You ready to go?
Yeah, let's go.
She says timidly.
Oh, yeah.
A few minutes later. All right, so we found a little umbrella, salt, and a lime. What's left?
Sandals, yukata, and some tequila, she sighs.
Sarge can worry about that last part. Let's see if we can find that yukata. I mean, it's Japan. There's gotta be a place that sells them.
Right, let's start looking.
You and T-34 continue down the street a short ways before you ask...
Hey, T-34, I've only been at the school a little while, but I was wondering something.
Well, you might as well ask me. It's not like there's anyone else around here that will be able to tell you about tank school, unless we happen to run into Sherman again.
So, what do we ask? We can ask about the students, we can ask about the gunny, or we can ask about IS-2. I'm going to steer clear of IS-2. Things seem to be going pretty well. And merely mentioning her seems to summon her from the pits of hell. Sippy says students. What else? What else? Any others? There's six of you. Who are the six? Dallows? Yeah. God damn it, man! No, we're not asking about IS-2. Alright, we'll ask about students. Tell me about the other students in the class.
Well, Sherman and I are friends. Our families haven't always exactly gotten along, but we're pretty similar deep down.
Hey, Mithril!
I mean, we've only had a couple of small fights. She's the only other tank I know that I know much about other than IS-2, but I tend to avoid her. I can't really tell you much about others.
Hey, Lild. Alright. You guys enjoying the show? Why is that?
Oh, I don't know. It's just the history I've had with Panzer and Tiger. Things between us have been pretty explosive. I only tolerate their presence around others. Tiger isn't so bad, really distant. It's just Panzer I can't stand being around. Everyone knows how quickly I escalate things. It's not like it's my fault or anything, though. I was made this way. So I just tend to avoid hanging out with anyone other than Sherman.
I don't think you should be too worried about that. I'm sure Panzer and Tiger would welcome your company. I mean, look at how fast they started dragging me along. Just give them a chance. I'm sure they'd be willing to give you one.
You really think so?
Absolutely.
I guess it would be worth a try.
Hey, T-34, it's a clothing store. I figured we'd find one eventually. Let's go inside and see what we can find.
All right.
You enter the store and clothesline all the aisles. In the back, you can see some more traditional Japanese garments. And by the register, there are plenty of different choices for swimwear. Do 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 do. Man, there are so many different kinds of clothes in here. Hey, I wonder if I can get a Kuromori Mine jacket. Different patterns can serve nicely for different purposes. Camouflage isn't just about the woods or the desert. It's about blending in with the environment, no matter where you are. Yeah, I never really looked at clothes that way. A good armored skirt and a decent pair of guns is all a good tank really needs. Whoa! Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Pair of guns, huh? Is that a little A cup angst from our little T-chan? Right! I don't get with what the gunny wants with these kind of clothes anyway. They're just so bourgeois. You know what? Forget his errands for now. We can look around if you want. Now you're talking. I still don't have anything efficient for beach ops, though I rarely ever have to conduct them. She starts walking over to the swimsuit section and stops. You don't have to come with me or anything. Oh, sorry, should be more of a... you don't have to come with me or anything. It's no problem. Maybe I can help you pick something out. Okay. She says, looking shy. You both continue into the swimsuit section. Love's your touch is fine. You know, I think this white one would look great on you. Well, it's not like I asked you or anything. But you really think so? Of course! Thanks, Erwin. I might as well see if it works. My frame isn't really used to amphibious attachments. She takes the white bathing suit and goes off to change. I asked about the background noise. I'm sorry, guys. I can't really do much about it. Is it really distracting? Or are you just referring to my singing the Soviet anthem? Because I can find other things. Anyway, she goes off to change. After a few moments... After a few moments, she comes back wearing the new bikini. Oh, God. Enjoy your watch list, gentlemen.
So, how does it look?
Compliment! Damn! You look beautiful.
What? Don't say things like that, but, like...
Her face turns red.
But do you really think so?
I'm getting text updates from members of the audience.
Do you really think so, Erwin?
Of course, it's really nice on you.
All right, then this one is sufficient. I shall purchase it. Thank you, Erwin.
Uh-oh. What is this video? What is this video? Was haben Sie? Was haben Sie?
He's in, boys! He did it! He said it!
Oh, my friend, we are nowhere near that point! No, 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 no!
It gets better, comrade.
She goes back to change into her school clothes. Thanks, school ain't bad. Ain't bad at all. Anyway, let's head back to beach. Gunny can figure out his clothing and alcohol needs on his own. We sure she's Russian? Oh, shit, that was supposed to be Irwin's line. Alright, well, we're flipping him. Sounds good to me. T-34 pays for a swimsuit and you walk towards the beach. Looks like we made it back to the beach before everyone else. Man, what a day. You said it. Whew. Yeah, thanks for letting me tag along, T-34. That was fun. Yeah, it was. I guess. Thanks for going with me, too. After a couple of minutes, the rest of the tanks begin arriving back at the beach. And the gummy begins approaching from his beach chair in the distance. As he gets nearer, all the tanks begin to laugh. Once he is close enough for you to make out his face clearly, you break out into laughter. Oh, Jesus. Something funny, recruit? No, Sergeant. That's just what I have, Sergeant. Enjoyed his day at the beach. Perfectly well, recruit. Now, y'all have the rest of the evening off. But you better be in class on time come tomorrow. This means you, Sherman!
Hi, Senpai.
Oh god, that was almost Alec Guinness. You can't do Keanu Reeves in short bits. It doesn't sound like anything.
There's a fireworks festival happening tonight, and the last thing I want to hear is the sound of explosions in the night. Get your shit in gear, and I will see you tomorrow, tanks and recruit.
Very true, Scipio. Very true. The tanks all begin splitting off to go back into town, and T-34 stays back to talk with the gunny. Uh-oh. Once she's done, you walk up to her.
Hey, T-34. I was wondering if you'd maybe like to go see those fireworks together?
Well, sure. It's not like I have anything better to do.
Great! Let's go then!
Okay.
After a good 30-minute hike up the hill, you start nearing the summit. T-34 has been quiet most of the way, but you catch a glimpse of her staring at you and blushing every so often.
Дружбе народов надежный оплот.
A few minutes later, you crest the top of the hill. Ah, piano of doom! Do you think this is the place?
How should I know? Maybe I don't see anything yet.
Well, it's pretty dark already. They should be starting soon.
Always liked fireworks. They remind me of the Great Patriotic War.
What's that?
I believe you capitalists call it World War II or something similar.
Right, World War II. Well, to me, fireworks always remind me of my father. What?
Oh, how so?
Well, when I was really little, he would take me out to watch them together on the 4th of July. Family. That's sweet. Yeah, we'd be out in this big in the meadow near my house. You could hear the cicadas in the tree line nearby. I was pretty young, though, so when the first firework of the night went off, I'd get scared. Grab his hand really tight.
That's adorable enough to warrant Siberia. So do you still stay in touch? With your father, I mean.
Oh, no, he died when I was pretty young.
Fighting against the plane girls. Plane girls! So there's tank girls, there's plane girls. And you all know there are ship girls.
Oh, Erwin, I'm really sorry.
It's okay, it happened a long time ago. I mean, I know I shouldn't begrudge them, but I've hated flying ever since.
Well, if you ever need to talk about it, I'm here for you.
She takes your hand. Okay, frickin' piano gotta come down. Thanks, T-34. I know I really should... Ah!
Erwin, don't squeeze my hand so tight.
You know it's happening, Scipia! You know it's happening! There are sub-girls, Lild. There are. Iku? You? Goya? Are there... No, that doesn't exist in Japan. Okay, so, maybe I got scared, or I'm not scared. Oh, thank you for that charming comment, all of them, Mr. Leader. Okay, we're gonna show a little vulnerability. Alright, that spooked me big time.
Duh, is the Erwin afraid of a little shell?
Ah!
She squeezes your hand with the force of a medium tank.
Ow, 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 ow! I'm sorry, Erwin. Yeah, it's okay. I'm fine. You're pretty strong then, I guess.
She smiles at you.
The fireworks really are, you know, pretty though.
Yeah, it's nice being here with you.
You're really sweet for an American. I mean, thanks for helping me on scavenger hunt today.
This is faster than chat. God damn it! Use the chat! Stream is of dead. Whoa! Panzer Heart!
Kinda problem, Shannis Madel. Alright. I'm gonna give it a minute for the stream to catch up. Alright, are we good? Is the stream dead, guys? Shit. Okay.
Oh, really?
Huh.
Okay. That's not Russian. That's not Russian. Eh? So, how's my Russian? T-34 starts giggling.
Erwin, that's not Russian.
Anyway, it's Madel.
But thanks anyway.
Ah, right. Well, you're really sweet too.
What are you saying?
Well, I like spending time with you. Well, I.
She leans in closer to you.
Erwin, I was wondering if maybe I could get.
Ah! Rain! Not the Rasputitsa! My threads are going to get stuck in the mud up here!
Oh, let's get you inside then. Here, take my hand. Let's get back into town.
Oh, okay.
She takes your hand and you both start heading down the mountain.
Take a drink every time it happens, right? We got one for Sherman, one for the rain.
After a good 15 minutes of walking, you reach the train station.
Ah, thank God! Suck a blood!
Well, at least I didn't get too wet. Yeah. Oh well, it looks like my train is pulling in. Oh, so I guess I'll see you tomorrow?
Yes, I'd like that. Let's do this again sometime. Without the rain, though.
She smiles at you before getting on the train.
Oh yeah.
Bye, Erwin.
She shouts as the doors close.
Oh, Sippy, I'm gonna make you regret ever getting me this.
I should be getting home too. After the long train ride home, you finally reach your station. The walk home is short, but after a long day, each step feels like a mile. That's 1.609344 kilometers for you metric pricks. Finally, you reach your apartment. And then somebody logs off of AOL. The room is dark, and the moonlight casts shadows on the wall. You sit down on the bed and lay your head on the pillow, shoes and everything still on.
Rest.
Ah, what the hell?
I feel like...
at least I'm already dressed. Fuck it.
As you rush down the hallway towards the classroom, you begin muttering to yourself.
Man, I overslept. Damn it, I'm gonna get chewed out again. Stupid long-ass train ride home last night.
Suddenly, Sherman pokes her head out from one of the doors behind you and shouts,
"Hey, new guy!"
You turn around to face her.
"Over here."
"Sherman? What are you doing in that classroom? We're both late as hell."
Come on, Erwin. Get in here.
She waves you in. Oh, well, it's one of those sort of things. My lucky dip. As you enter the classroom, you see all the tanks in their seats. And the gunnies standing in the front. Blitzkrieg 101, Breslau or bust. German tank schedule.
Well, if recruit Lemoore would like to join us...
We could stop!
Sergeant, I...
Recruit Lemoore! I swear you couldn't navigate your way out of a map star!
This recruit didn't know if the classroom had been moved.
You couldn't have guessed when you saw the old one was still a smoking hole?
No one informed this recruit of the change, Drill Sergeant.
Thanks! You will give this maggot your phone number so that he may bother you instead of wasting my precious time.
Aye, Senpai. Here's, like, my number, Erwin. Send me a text so I can add you.
Sure. You send her a quick, it's Erwin message.
Awesome. I added you to our group chat.
Wait, what? Ah!
Sherman, I don't...
Oh, God. Want to be in the... God damn it, Sherman.
Sergeant, why do I have to give him my number?
You're a comet tank, Recruit 34. Aren't you supposed to love Sharon?
Suka!
All right, here, Erwin.
Thank you.
I promise I won't misuse it. That's a lie.
You better not. I get touchy with phone lines. You never know who is listening in.
Right.
You too, Recruit Tiger!
Oh, that was Ermy, not Southern. Oh well.
Sergeant, shouldn't Elfin give me his number too?
Ew, wait, that came out wrong. That came out wrong.
If this makes this go faster, recruit Lamar! Give Tiger your number!
Is there anything he doesn't scream about? Here, Tiger, I'm at 985-665-2500.
Yeah!
She whispers softly, oh ho, ho.
Target number 2, client!
Yes, Soviet Russia phone listen to you. Alright, so I guess I need... You're number 2, Panzer 4?
Sondern Kampffahrzeug Panzer Kampfwagen 4 Ausführung F!
I thought you were F2. Wait a minute, you F or F2, goddammit!
Recruit 4, your phone number, not your designation.
Oh, right. Here you go, Elvin.
Great, I'll call you if I have any questions. Please get away from me, you crazy Nazi bitch.
Very good, recruit. Lemoore, I expect you to be on time and prepared for everything from this moment forward. Now I am not Shania Twain in costume. You are very lucky I had a relaxing day yesterday, so I will spare your ass just this once!
Buffering in the...
However! Each of you will be providing each and every one of your classmates with 10 knee bends each. Now!
Ah, damn it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. A few hours later. Oh, buffered in the middle of the German. Goddamn. Do you know how hard it is to say Sonderkraftfahrzeug Panzerkampfwagen 4 F Ausführung F2? Not that hard, actually. That was a killer test. I'm bushed. Yeah, shut up when you take one on mass spectrometry. Ah! Elvin! What? Don't pop up out of nowhere like that.
Erwin, I have a question for you.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, tovarish, you must think long and hard about this coming question. It is matter of state security.
Ha, fuck. State security.
Duh.
She is rather Alma-ish.
Do not be of the worrying. Question is easy in and of itself. Answer, not so much.
Thanks for clarifying.
No, I ask question. Are you prepared?
Yeah, sure.
All right. What did you get on question?
Oh, sorry.
What did you get on question 42?
I don't remember, IS2.
Don't withhold information from me. Hoarding information. That is the way of the capitalist tsarist pigs. They steal information from the people. Use it for their own gains.
Oh, look, I'm in OD. Talking to Dimmy.
Stealing is not...
Oh, God, she went Arnold there. I'm trying to think of one of my professors.
Stealing is not the Soviet way, comrade.
I'm not hoarding, stealing, anything. I just don't remember. Oh, shit.
We have ways to make people remember. Glory to Arstotzka.
Ah, fine, it's... God, what the hell? Okay, folks. So, question 42 is the answer of the Treaty of Versailles. 42, 23 apples. I'm guessing it's not St. Oh my God, no, no, not St. Petersburg for dinner. No, 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 that's how you get kidnapped. No, 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 no. You can't run. You can't hide. I see a 42, I see a 23 apples. Two 42s. I do hope you guys are having fun. Because I am. This is great. If no, then yes. Alright, 42 it is.
Da is very good. I got same answer.
Right. Well,
have nice day, comrade.
What a fucking nut. I'm going home.
Hans, a point of view, Anakin.
Finally, I'm home. Oh, someone signed off AOL again. Oh, man, tomorrow is Saturday, too. But today is Saturday. Oh, I can't wait. God, I have the entire day to myself. Oh,
Kaga. My next Kanga.
Morning! This is gonna be awesome! No tanks! No gunny! No weird shit! Ah, there are so many things I can accomplish. I'm gonna open up the curtains and greet the day! Hello, son! Ah, what to do today? Yeah. Lol. Tra-la-lol. Tra-la-la-lol. Shit! Alright, that's it. I'm calling someone. Who do I call, though? Well, there's a wide selection. Oh, here goes nothing. Ring, 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 ring. Banana phone. Duh. T-34 speaking. Oh, hey, T-34. Funny to hear you here. Shit, what was that? I was just going to ask if you wanted to possibly, you see... Erwin, I'm very busy. This better not be a personal call. Do you want to go on a date? What did I say about using this line? So you don't want to? Tomorrow at noon is fine. Wait, what? Where are we going? The park. Don't be late. She slams the phone down. And the line goes dead. I don't know if I just got myself a date or a death warrant. Okay. Well, guess we'll find out in the morning. You arrive at the park with barely a minute to spare. He's out, boys! He's out! Ah, that's what you think, my friend! Oh, look, we're at the Stalingrad Park! In Japan. Japan, why you do this? Further into the park, you can see T-34 already waiting for you, tapping her foot impatiently. As you approach, she smiles shyly. Hey, T-34, you look really nice today. Oh, thanks. Are you sure about this whole date thing? I have other things I need to... Of course I am. Come on, let's go. Ah, alright then. Japan in grad? Why is hell not on Earth? As you and T-34 walk through the park together, you come upon an ice cream stand. Ooh, ice cream! Best game ever! Hey, that ice cream looks good. Let's get some. My treat. Sure. Yeah, of course you are, you fucking communist. As long as someone else is paying. Hope he's not here, right? I'll have an ice cream mochi. Is that the one with a face? Yeah, Panzer IV got me to that kawaii destiny shit. That's more of a Congo kind of thing, but okay.
Germans. They use picometers for the crystallographic surveys. You use angstrom!
Huh?
Nothing.
I'll have vanilla...
Sorry.
I'll have vanilla ice cream.
Extra ice.
Hold vanilla.
What?
The shopkeeper hands you your ice cream and T-34 her ice.
T-34,
T-34 confirmed for meth addict. Or dealer. And the ice cream shop is the distribution point. You and T-34 sit down on a bench together and start eating. Also, you notice how the Russian girls both have red eyes. The German girls have blonde hair and blue eyes. A few minutes later... And then the cunny gave me this weird look and said,
"We ain't making no goddamn cornflakes here. Get your ass in gear."
Yeah, the gunny is really something.
You know, I've never seen this part of the park before. It's really beautiful.
Yeah, almost as pretty as you.
What's it supposed to mean?
That means that, well,
I think you're as beautiful as these roses.
A little red communist rose. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Oh, thank you, she says, as her cheeks grow ever more red like the banner of the worker.
Come on, let's keep going. Maybe we'll find something else here that you haven't seen before.
All right.
You and T-34 continue walking through the park, and around the bend in the path you see a peaceful pond. Ah, much peaceful. Very wow. As you approach, you can see the evening sun reflecting off the crystal clear blue water. And you and T-34 sit down in a grassy knoll near the pond's edge.
Erwin, I have trick. Find me a president, and I show you good trick from grassy knoll.
So, tell me more about your family, T-34. I already know IS-2. What about the rest of them?
Why do you want to know about my family?
Well, I'm interested in what your life is like.
Oh, okay. Well, you've already met crazy side, IS-2. My cousin on other side of the family, KV-2, is more balanced. She's a nice girl, but sometimes kind of slow. And not really the quickest runner either, if you get what I mean.
Yeah. Yeah. The KV-2 is a special kind of tank. It really needs to be seen to be believed. But somebody thought this thing was a militarily sound design. That's a KV-2. Paste it in the chat. Also, hello, new person. I do not know who you are, but hello.
Anyhow, my older sisters never really amounted to much. So there's a lot of pressure on me to succeed. Not that I can't handle it.
Yeah, it must be hard for you sometimes, though. I can relate.
Oh, how so?
Well, my mother always said that my great-grandfather was some kind of war hero, so I feel like I have to live up to that in some way.
Try getting relegated from pride of the motherland to being main battle tank for countries like Congo and Somalia.
Wait, you're still
in service? Duh. I still moonlight on the front when I can.
With your age, I ne- Oh shit.
I'm going to give you about 3 seconds to rephrase that.
Ah!
I mean, I'm impressed by how long you've been in service.
Better. Anyway, let's head out. He's getting late.
Sure.
You and T-34 continue walking through the park and begin nearing the pathway out. As you walk, you feel T-34's hand brush against yours more than once. And again. And again. You take her hand. Out of the corner of your eye, you see her smiling to herself.
Здравствуйте, яблони и груши.
Around the next bend in the path, you come to the exit.
Oh, well, there's the way out.
Yeah, I guess we should both get going then.
Well, there was something I was wondering first.
Yeah, sure. What is it?
Well, why did you ask me to come with you?
Oh dear.
Okay, decision time.
Look, they even arranged it like the Mass Effect choices. Well, not quite. They flipped center and upper right. But they put lower right and they put bottom choice in exactly the right spot. Alright. So, eeny, meeny, miny. There's no way out.
Nope. We are too far committed.
We march till we win or we die.
Ha ha!
Well, because I really, really like you.
Oh, it's really nice, Erwin.
I think I should probably be on my way now.
She gives you a light hug before quickly scampering out of the park.
Rich, shut up!
I swear to God, if you watch the LP of this, I will hurt you. Definitely not one for the romance, huh? Yeah, she's a tsundere. She loves it, she just won't show it.
Ah, well, I can't say that was the best date I've been on, but it could have gone worse. What the fuck went wrong with it? I guess I'll see him at school on Monday.
I have to hang for now.
T-34? You wanna get in a hot tub? Me and Congo? Kaga?
You sit at your desk, eating lunch.
If she's an ice cream, we know how to defrost.
You know, for how weird this place is, a guy could get used to it.
And hell, this bento thing ain't half a bad idea.
Suddenly, Panzerkampfwagen 4 Ausführung F2 bursts into the room.
Elvin!
Why are you just sitting in here alone for lunch?
What? I'm just trying to eat!
Alvin! You should try and be more social! Like me! I am nationally social!
Well, what would you have me do? I just wanted to eat my lunch!
Alvin, it's Japan! Join a club!
I'm fine, really. I don't do club.
Don't be a spoil sport. Come on!
She grabs you by the arm and begins marching you towards the door.
Where are we going? To our club meeting, silly. It's Monday.
Panzer 4 pulls you into the room behind her. And a variety of students are already sitting around waiting for the meeting to start.
And Shorty Kong, here is Irvin, and he's joining a club today. Whoa, wait, no, I...
Suddenly, a taller girl grabs you from behind.
Oh, so you're the Irvin Panzer Force always talking about...
Wait, excuse me.
Oh. So you're the Irvin Panzer Force always talking about...
What?
You pry her off your shoulders and turn around to face her.
Oh, look, Panzer Four, he's blushing.
Cut it out, mouse!
Is the little Panzer Four shy?
Nein, it's... I...
You both know I'm right here.
Erwin,
I didn't know you were joining a club.
I'm not!
Woohoo! Erwin's joining a club, man. Come on, tankery, tank.
Oh shit, I wanna join the tankery team, fuck yeah! Wait a minute, how do you do tankery when the girls are tanks? I can't do Clint Eastwood.
We don't have a tankery team anymore, Sherman! Or did you forget? We are blacklisted!
Oh, come on, Frenchie! Nobody said I had to stay on the aircraft carrier, man!
Yes, aircraft carriers!
Aye, yes!
But see, I don't want to do tankery with you guys, I want to do it at Kuromori Mine, because they get the cool jacket.
That's not the point!
What about that pipe down? We have business to discuss!
I really, really apologize for the accent, by the way. That's as close as I can get without being horribly, horribly bad based on how I've heard professors talk. The tanks all reply, "Aye, Vice President!" and take their places around the room, grouping by club. Aha! So you're the Nadashiko of this group.
Or you're... Yuzu!
Haha! Go wash a tank!
Alright!
That's Kennedy.
Alright! Now that everyone is here, let us get this thing started. As I'm sure you all know, this weekend is our school-wide hot springs trip. Unfortunately though, with the damage caused by an errant HE shell to Classroom 3B, by Sherman, our class treasury is 300,000 yen in the red.
Their conversion factors are miserable.
You're telling me those repairs almost cost $3,000?
You're one to talk, Sherman. Try watching where you shoot sometime.
Hey, man, it's not my fault the ammo was faulty.
Maybe if your commie buddy China could get the quality control in check.
Ooh!
Don't try and turn this around on me, Sherman.
Come on, both of you! Sophie P is trying to talk!
As I was saying, I'm really sorry, but the trip will have to be cancelled.
Quoi? Cancelled?
That's no fair, ma chérie! Look, this isn't up to me.
Hey,
Yeah, I want to go on the trip.
Sherman!
I have a... What is?
I have an idea!
Everyone falls silent.
I... have an idea? Ah, shit!
Go ahead.
Well, what if all the clubs did something to raise money before this weekend?
Well, that might just work. I would have to get the president's approval. But yes, this could save the trip.
What sort of thing?
My apologies.
What sort of thing could raise $3,000 in 1 week?
I can think of a few things. I never thought that far ahead.
It doesn't have to be one thing. Each club just needs to raise their part.
Let me think.
I will ask the president to let the student council do a donation drive. School newspaper, why don't you make some special print run?
Da! Pravda can do that.
The newspaper club agrees before exiting. Ah, so she works for the newspaper.
Like the music club, you can all hold the concert.
I cannot do a Polish accent. So, she spent time in England.
Hi, we'll make you proud, P.P. Senpai.
The light music club all echoes before leaving the room.
Oh, what can the occult studies group...
Sorry, that was too Arnold.
Oh, what can the occult studies group do?
I don't know. Just no spooky stuff this time. Please.
All right. Come on, team. Let's go get the ritual garb.
The German tanks all shuffle out of the room.
Hey!
Wait, I said hug! Someone go make sure they don't try and kill anything.
It sounded like Goldfinger. Oh, God.
Hey, man, you forgot the tankery team.
I remembered to forget.
No fair, man. We're helping, too.
Fine. Just go make yourselves useful.
On it!
She shouts as the tankery team runs out of the room. Oh, God. What do I do?
Oh! Erwin, I am sorry. I almost forgot you were here.
Thanks.
Why don't you try and help out some of the clubs this week? I'm sure they could use it.
Sure, I'll see what I can do.
Es braust unser Panzer.
Have to click to advance. I should probably help out one of the clubs before I go home. But T-34 is swamped with the newspaper. God knows what Sherman's gotten up to. Who do I help first? I can help the Nua Paper Club. Or the Tankery Club.
Why is that electronic mouse record at the next station? No problem. It's a pretty huge file.
So, I'm guessing if I go to the Tankery Club with Sherman, I'm probably going to get shot again. So, we'll go visit the waifu. I guess I should see how things are at the newspaper. How things at the newspaper are coming along. I'm sure it can't have gone too bad yet. I mean, at least FT-34, she's usually pretty level-headed. You enter the school newspaper club room and are immediately hit by the droning sound of printing presses chugging away. All throughout the room, tanks are running every which way, and near the window, T-34 is standing next to a taller girl who is pacing back and forth rapidly.
Comrade Commissar, the numbers are back for last month's circulation.
IS-2-152.
Da! And how do they look?
Unfortunately, they are down. Again.
But!
Well, I...
What?
The Port Bureau will have our heads for this.
Shuka.
Well, how many? Give me the numbers.
In total, we distributed 3 copies.
That's including one for the teacher's lounge and one for our waiting room.
Conrad, pass me my talkerif. I'll save everyone the trouble.
Suddenly, another tank rushes into the room. She strains to speak, but is short on breath.
Sacre bleu! Vite! Vite! Y'all... ruined it!
Ruined what, comrade?
My story!
Nobody ruined...
Nobody ruined anything. We just did some fact-checking.
Fact-checking? How is this fact-checking?
She slams a copy of the newspaper on the desk. IS-2152 picks it up and scans down the page quickly.
I don't see any errors.
Tovarish. The other girl snatches the paper back quickly and points to the first headline.
Ahem. Heroic defender of the motherland holds off entire German armored division with only bayonet and flag? And here, Zeit magazine poll. Putin voted best religious leader of last three...
My French is turning Russian.
Putin voted best religious leader of last 3,000 years. What is that? And 136% of Crimeans agree. Ukraine failed state succession. Secession is answer? Duh.
I made them up myself.
Exactly. You cannot just print things you make up.
What? Why not?
Because it's not true.
Why let the fix get in the way of good story?
Duh.
Duh. I must agree with smaller Russian tank.
Paper is called Pravda. This means truth. Whatever we print is officially sanctioned party line.
Sacre bleu, you are all insufferable.
They all turn to look at you. Ah, I don't mean to barge in, but I was wondering if you needed help with the paper?
What? Help? The Soviet motherland needs no help from American capital.
Comrade, we sold 3 copies last month. I believe we need all the help we can get.
Oh, nobody is listening. We are not going to sell a single paper if you Russian tanks keep making up whatever suits you.
I hate to agree with the French on something, but she is right. You can't just make things up and call it fact. You're not Democrats.
Yet is not making things up. Is only reinterpreting truth.
Oh, shit. Wrong button.
either way.
Maybe try doing something besides historical pieces for this issue.
What? What else is there to write about except the good old days?
Does she really need to say fuck that often? That's what blot means.
Do an interview, an op-ed.
Anything besides history?
Duh. I like. T-34. Get him a camera and a party member card.
I'll just stick with the camera for now.
Just follow me, Owen. I'll do the writing and you take the pictures.
Yeah, I haven't heard that from a Bond villain before. Oh, wait. Sure, right.
You and Char B1 leave the newspaper club room and head into the hallway.
They're just impossible, you know? She pouts.
Screw you, Frenchie. They try their best. I mean, being an editor isn't always easy, and I can actually speak from personal experience on that. Plus, I'm pretty sure that Putin poll is accurate.
They shall still ask me before they censor all my stories.
Anyway, I do not think that I have fully introduced myself.
God, I cannot do a French accent, guys. I'm really sorry.
I do not think I have fully introduced myself yet. I am Charles de Bataillon from Boulogne, France.
Chair de Battle A Bologna?
Ah! You Americans butcher a beautiful language with your English tones.
Well, that's fitting at least. Hey, at least we pronounce the letters we put in our words.
Sacre bleu! I'll let that one go for now, though. Let's get this assignment done first, and then we can discuss your uncivilized language further.
It's a date. You wink.
No! Nine!
I shall hold you to it, American. Anyway, we should probably find someone to do a story on. Do you have any ideas?
Damn. I'm not sure.
Oh, that's it.
What?
I shall interview the Marshal de Logis chef.
The gunny. Please don't say you mean the gunny.
But of course, oh, we shall interview him today. Let's go.
God, no! Ah, fine, let's just get it over with. Fuck.
You and Char B1 stroll down the hallway towards the classroom. You knock on the door lightly and step inside.
Blitzkrieg 101, Breslau Oberst.
Sir, I was wondering if I could...
God! Damn it, recruit! I will!
Mon sergeant!
Oh, mon charbon! I can't read that!
Alright.
Comment allez-vous aujourd'hui? Et c'est peu de la merde vous donne de ennui?
No idea.
Wait, what the fuck? Recruit, do not swear in front of a lady! Why? How are you...
Why are you speaking French? For the love of recruit, don't you know the first thing about romance?
Charby one giggles to herself.
No, mon sergeant.
God, can we just get an interview for the paper?
You want to put me in the paper?
Oui.
Well, I'll be darned. If you want to put my mug in the paper, well, why not? When's it going to print?
This week, I think.
Well, I might just have to pick myself up a copy.
Baby. Sounded decent. What? Which part sounded decent of my horrible, horrible French? Give me Russian, give me German, I'm fine. I might even be able to pull off Japanese and Chinese. Forget French. Because they don't pronounce the letters they use.
Mon sergent, could you answer a few questions for me?
Go ahead.
All right, well, to start, could we get your full name and rank?
There's no such grade.
Gunnery Sergeant Major R. Lee Hartman.
What sort of rank is Gunnery Sergeant Major?
For love of recruit, haven't you ever heard of a first name?
What sort of name is Major?
And what was your job in the military before you became a drill instructor?
I was a 6969 Space Shuttle Door Gunner. Well, that sort of job, why did you become a drill sergeant?
Well, you see, recruit, for some Marines, the amount of
for sodomy that the military does to us takes its toll in a different way. Instead of retiring, anger wells up inside of us to the point where we forget where we come from.
We wish for nothing more than to spread this malice and hate to the next generation of boots.
And so, a drill instructor is born. I think I just shifted across 27 different dialects there. Right, Sergeant.
What's your biggest pet peeve? When boots put their goddamn darn hands in their darn pockets.
Why does it matter if our hands are in our pockets?
Recruit, do you know why Hitler lost the war?
Because the Russians were able to outproduce the German industrial capacity?
No, recruit. Because he let the SS put their hands in their pockets!
Do you think we just take your photo and get going? Click goes the camera. Alright, let's get going, Char.
Oh, au revoir, Sasha.
She leaves the room. You start to leave, too.
Shit. Recruit! Yes, Sergeant?
If you ever want to get inside of a tank, it would behoove you to unfuck yourself!
Wanted to get that up for a while, Sergeant.
Yes, Recruit. Yes, I did.
Puppy's right, the writing in this is great. I just wish they proofread it. The rest of the day goes by quickly and you drift fast asleep that night. Tick. Tick.
At least I don't have any clubs to deal with today.
Heck, I could probably take the whole day off and nobody would notice.
Well, at least until Sarge kicks in my door.
I guess I can survive a few hours. No classes. You get out of bed and make your way to the school. Are you guys having fun with this? Because if it's getting boring, let me know.
Oh god, I can remember how to do a Japanese accent again.
Elwin, I need to ask you a favor.
Oh, Vice President, yeah, sure.
Well, it's about the Occult Studies Club.
Alright.
Well, it's just, can you please make sure they're not doing something satanic?
Satanic?
I don't want to have to hold another weekend safety briefing if they summon the Eldar Gods or something again.
Yeah, no problem. I'll go check in on them.
Thank you, Erwin. She smiles.
You head across the school grounds to the Occult Studies Club room. Oh, fuck. It's in one of the old, unused classrooms, and as you approach, a cold chill washes over you. Hello? Is anybody in there?
Kommen Sie zu uns, ihr Götter des Geldes. Schwören wir, dass wir dieses Mal schön...
You knock on the door. Knock, knock, knock.
So spoopy!
Hello? Alright, I'm coming in. Once you open the door, you can barely see more than a few feet in front of you, and smoke wafts throughout the room. On the black wall, you can see a large pentagram has been hastily drawn on the blackboard. What? The. Hell! Out of the smoke cloud, Panzer IV pops up in front of you. Elvin! Hey! Panzer IV, what the hell is this?
Ah! I'm so glad you're here! You made it just in time!
Do I even want to know? Alright, what for?
For some blood sacrifice, silly!
Complete with cheerful music! I love this game!
If we make an offering to the orphans, they will grant us some money to go on this trip!
Maybe the weapons to win the war. They can be a real fickle bunch. Remember when the Vice President said no spooky shit? This is the exact definition of spooky shit!
Oh, come on, that has a little blood magic hurt anyone, Des. Why the hell do you even know about this stuff? Just a little thing I picked up during the war.
Oh, shh! It's about time for the virgin sacrifice.
Virgin sacrifice?
Mm-hmm. They have a tank here who never saw combat. This is going to be a good one.
From another part of the room, Mouse steps forward. Okay, hell no. Call this thing off.
But how do you expect us to get some money? It's not like we're a bunch of I'm just made of money, people.
So for anyone wondering, the occult studies bit is a reference to the fact that the SS was ridiculously steeped in weird occult pagan practice shit as a rejection of the quote-unquote non-Germanic Judeo-Christian tradition that had basically become the mainstream in Europe at the time. And yes, she was referencing the Jews there. Either way, the Vice President just told me to come up here to make sure you weren't up to, well, exactly what the fuck you're up to.
Yeah, but...
No spooky shit. Hi, hi, she frowns.
Alright, good.
Then we can keep this little thing between you and me.
But, what are we going to do to raise some money, then?
She pouts.
God, I don't know. Just hold a bake sale or something.
Both their eyes light up, and Panzer IV grins.
I think we can do that, Nay.
Wait.
I see about buying some kitchen equipment. Shit!
I don't like where this is going. And I'll make sure not to burn them this sight. Okay, we're making Holocaust jokes. Great. Please.
And I forget. God, no. But I was going to say, get the door.
No. No, you weren't.
Don't be a spoiler spot to this. God help me.
Alright, cool. How about you two come to the store with me, and we get the dough together.
Shopping!
We love shopping!
Let's go. Jetzt geht's los, Fräulein.
Nice picture. Nice picture. You and the German tank girls walk a few blocks to go to the store.
Bing bong!
Oh, Ramune! I love Ramune!
Ramune, the noodle stuff!
It's a soda with a marble in it.
Ew, why would you eat a marble?
You don't eat some marble, Mouse Chan!
Then what's the point of the marble?
It's cute!
Did I miss something?
No, it's just Panzer IV being, Panzer IV.
OMG, this little cat often mit is so kawaii!
I mean, we already have Mitch back at school. We're really just here for ingredients.
Mouse. Oh, Mouse. Cats scare me.
Huh?
Ooh! Here! Authentic Japanese shoyu!
Soy sauce.
Wow, Irvin. You're really smart.
What are we here for again?
Eggs, flour, chocolate chips, milk, olive oil, butter.
Oh, squid!
Panzer IV shouts as she runs off down the aisle.
Squid scare me too.
Wait! Don't leave! I can't keep up with her.
It's okay, Owen. I can't even keep up with infantry. Ha ha ha.
She gets a bit odd when she's around Japanese stuff. I mean, besides that, she's pretty much everything you could want for in the tank.
There's nothing else you could want? Do you really mean that?
Is that what you're saying? There's nothing else you could want!
You know, I never did see service.
Okay, too many K's.
I'm back! Did you miss me?
Don't tell them to bake things yet, too late for that. Yes, and please get your cousin to stop hitting on me.
Duh, Panzer IV, you always pick the shy ones, don't you?
She giggles.
I'm very stuck-like.
Please. You both bore me. Get out of my sight.
What did you find?
Oh, just some milk, eggs, pocket, flour, sugar, wasabi. Oh, and a German claim on Breslau.
I don't think we need wasabi for the bake sale.
So Breslau still on the plate? God, please. Put back all that extra junk. But I'm hungry.
Alright. Are you hungry too, Mouse?
Lunch sounds good. I'm so hungry I could down a munitions dump for food.
Ow. Sorry, I tried to get that ugh out and I choked on it.
Ugh, I'm so jealous, Mouse. Anything you eat just goes straight to your... Help me out here, Irvin!
I'm leaving you hanging. You know what? I am staying out of this one.
Gah! Irvin Bakker, I was going to say hips!
You know, as much as I'd like to keep hearing this discussion, don't we have a bake sale to run?
Food first, bake later.
Alright, what are you feeling like for food?
I'm feeling a little like Poland. Polish sausage. Yeah, Polandish sausage sounds so good right now.
You guys are fucking weird. The next day.
Alright, everyone. I'm sure you know why I've called you here.
Ooh, the Allies have capitulated?
No, it's the...
Like, our ban appeal has been approved, man?
No. Would you let me finish?
Ah, you found the Light Music Club enough money to buy our first instrument.
Poor Polish girl.
No!
Wait. Do you even go to this school?
Who are you again?
I'm 7TP.
What country are you from?
Poland.
Like, is that still a country?
Of course! Poland is one of the oldest countries in Europe!
Duh, Poland is small Soviet province.
Poland cannot into relevant.
That's awesome! You could totally join my club, my after-school club, then!
Bob, you're not helping.
Mm-hmm. As I was saying, I've called you all here to announce the results of our fundraising drive. Thanks to everyone pulling together and working as a team, we raised a grand total of 290,000 yen.
So, we're short 10,000?
I am really sorry, everyone. I know how hard you work.
Hold it right there, you lot.
Sarge! You maggots are not spending the weekend here. I've been waiting all year for this trip, and recruits them or inability to bounce a tank shell is not screwing this up for me now.
Sarge, I don't really think that's the cause of the...
God damn it, recruit, let me finish. I was assigned to chaperone this trip, and there's no way in hell I'm missing out on it. The train leaves at 0600. Get your shitting gear and get there on time, tanks.
Are you saying that you're paying for the...
God damn it, recruit. I bet your mother wish she swallowed you. Dismissed!
The train ride is smooth and quiet for once. In fact, you might be the only ones actually on the train. The tank girls have split off into two groups.
Tiger and Panzer IV sit next to each other, giggling and pointing out the windows, while Sherman annoys T-34 with their constant yammering.
Hello, Fräulein!
Hey, you two mind if I sit here?
Sure, sit down, Erwin.
That's fine. It's fine, I guess.
Thanks. So, what are you two talking about?
That was the best tank of World War II.
I wouldn't say that.
Most flammable, though, sure.
Sure.
Well, without me...
Oh, sorry.
Well, man, without me, you'd still be at odds with Panzer IV and Tiger.
I am the product of a generation's great patriotic struggle against the evils of fascism and hatred. I am a miracle of technical...
Blah, blah, blah. I can't hear you over the sound of D-Day. Wicked waves, man.
Ladies. Oh, shit. Oh, shit!
Let's let Erwin decide.
No.
Yeah, come on, Erwin. Which one of us was better?
The Stork! We go with the Stork!
We don't go with the Stork.
I want to say the Stork, because Erwin drives the Stork, dammit!
Nah, we're going T-34.
Well, personally, I've always thought...
The train shakes violently as it enters a tunnel and all the lights go dark. Done. It feels like it might skip a rail and fly off into the mountainside. And that's how we die.
Well, what was that?
Not a clue.
I'm still not used to being inside trains.
Tanks aren't meant to be inside of them, only on top.
You're telling me, comrade.
A few moments later, lights flicker back on.
Phew, that was scary.
I hope we're getting close. That felt like we were gonna crash.
Trains crash all the time. Although I imagine if it did, Sherman and I would be okay. But you'd be... Oh.
But you'd be jelly! You jelly, bro?
Especially if one of us landed on you, comrade.
You know, in training, they always tell us to drive towards the center of a rolling vehicle. To dive towards the center of a rolling vehicle.
Oh, does that keep you safer?
No, it just helps keep the blood off the seats. That's no joking matter. That's no joking matter, Erwin. You've almost died twice since you've gotten here.
Twice? Yeah, I guess Tiger almost ran me over.
Yeah! And you almost took an HE shell to the face!
That you fired, Sherman!
I was just following orders.
Where have I heard that before?
My right ear is still ringing.
You're lucky it's still attached.
Ew, icky!
Sherman!
Lighten up, new guy. Come on, it looks like we're here.
So, should I call it a break here? I think I'll call it a break here. My voice is getting shot anyway. Thank you for coming, guys. to my first Twitch stream. I'll try to do stuff that's less fucked up in the future.
Ich hab's in die Gesicht, doch ist uns ansehen, ja uns ansehen. Es braust unser Panzer im Stürmwind dahin.